Hello, welcome to Arvind Singh Academy. We are discussing mathematical tool and this is lecture number 10. I hope you have already watched part 1 to part 9 before watching this part 10. Although this is an independent topic that is we are going to discuss today, even though you have not watched any of the previous topic, you will be able to understand it. This is a differentiation and we are going to start today differentiation. So let me explain this, the basic of differentiation, what is differentiation and why it is important in physics. Differentiation. Right? Differentiation. So why differentiation is important? And what is the meaning of differentiation? You know, there are function is if x and y are any two variable, x and y are any two variables in which value of y depends on value of x, and they are defined as y is a function of x such that for every value of x there is unique value of y, right? So x is called independent variable, then x is called independent variable, and since value of y depends on the value of x, right now, so we will say value of y depends on value of x, and therefore Hence, y is called dependent variable, right? So to explain this, if y is equal to fx be any function, say y is equal to fx be any function. So if there is any change in x, there will be corresponding change in y as well, right? Now this is x, say just like when you are moving in a grocery shop and you find that there is an span, this is there is a pan in which shopkeepers are weighing something, and if you increase the weight here, write this, and there is two pans, and on these two pans, one side they used to put weight, and other side they used to put items or goods, right? So say like this, this is say. So consider the simple weighing balance. If a shopkeeper puts some goods here in this side, say goods here in this side, and accordingly there is a weight in this side also, right? If goods are increased something, then weight is also correspondingly increases. Means if there is a change in this side, there will be correspondingly change in that side also. So if delta x will be very small change, very small change in x, very small change in x, change in x, then since value of y depends on x, so when x will change, y will also change, then value of y will also change correspondingly, right? So value of x also change correspondingly, and it will become y plus delta y is equal to f of x plus delta x. This is said to be equation 2, right? So why? Say just for example, for more clarification, I'm giving here one example. Y is equal to x square. Got it? And if x is equal to 1, y is also 1. Value of y depends on x. If x is 2, y is 4, right? If x is 3, y is 9. So here, change in x takes place, just 1, but change in y will be here 3, this side 3 changes, and here there is 5 changes. So changes in y will depend on changes in x, but even a small change in x, there will be corresponding change in y, but change in y is not homogeneous, not uniform. It may not be uniform. Here, what is the difference? The difference is here 3, and in these two difference is 5. Just changing by 1, the difference is 3 changes in y, and one more changes will bring them 5 changes in y. So it is not homogeneous, but definitely one thing is sure, that if there is any change in x, there will be corresponding change in y as well. So if there is change in x, there will be change in y. Now we can subtract second minus first. Subtract second minus first. We get, what is that? Y plus delta y minus y is equal to fx plus delta x minus fx. Right now, y and y cancels. Now, if you want to, because this delta y change because of the delta x change, right now, so the value of y will change correspondingly by delta y. Here I can write by delta y, right now. So this delta x, delta y changes because of delta x changes. So think like this: if there is a delta x changes in x, then there is change in y. If there is unit changes, then there must be equal to delta y by delta x. So to find this, divide both the sides by delta x. Divide both the sides by delta x. By delta x. Both the sides by delta x. We get. What is that? Then delta y upon delta x is equal to, what will happen? That will be f of x plus delta x minus fx whole divided by delta x. As we had discussed here, that delta x is very small. Delta x is very small. Right? So delta x is so small that it tending to zero. So we'll write, that is called limit. And limit, if I'll write here limit delta x tends to zero, we can write it like this. Limit, in short, we'll write just LT, delta x tends to 0, then delta y by delta x is equal to limit delta x tends to 0, again, limit delta x tends to 0, f of x plus delta x minus fx divided by delta x, and this one is called dy by dx. this whole one is called dy by dx. I hope you got it. So this is by definition is called dy by dx, rate of change of y with respect to x. This one is defined as dy by dx limit delta x tends to 0, limit or LT is the same thing, fx plus delta x minus fx whole divided by delta x. That is called differential coefficient of y, that is change in y with respect when there is change in x. So dy, literal meaning of dy by dx is rate of change of y with respect to x when x is changed. So dy by dx, the literal meaning of dy by dx is nothing else, dy by dx is meaning is rate of change in y when there is with respect to x, you can say with respect to x, rate of change of y with respect to x, that is there is change in y when there is change in x, and read as the differential coefficient, it is read as differential coefficient of y with respect to x, right? Na? Differential coefficient of y with respect to x. So we have some formula accordingly. Differential coefficient of any constant term dy dx of any constant term is 0. Why? Because if there is change in y is equal to c, if just see the concept, y is equal to fx, but fx is c. So if there is change, there is no change because it is a constant now. So there is no change, and no change takes place means there will be 0. If c will not change, then how y will change? Y will not change, isn't it? Because y is a function of x. If there is a x change in x, then change in y as well. But if there is no change because it is a constant term, so there is no change in y. So rate of change is 0. I hope you got it. Now the second thing is that there are some formula dy dx of sine x. Before this, I should write here x to the power n is n x to the power n minus 1. Dy dx of x to the power n is n x to the power n minus 1. Similarly, there are some formula dy dx of sine x is cos x, dy dx of cos x is minus sine x, right now. Similarly, we can write some more formula dy dx of, you have to remember this, dy dx of, right now, that will be like this. So dy dx of tan x is sec square x, dy dx of cot x is minus cosec square x, dy dx of sec x is sec x tan x, dy dx of cosec x is minus cosec x cot x. So remember, those who will start with C, cos or cosec, they will have negative sign, rest of them has positive sign. So you can memorize like this also. Now some more formula is there, and that you can learn here because it is also equally useful. E to the power x, derivative of e to the power x is e to the power x, and derivative of log x is 1 by x, right? Na? So these are some more formula. Remember, this is a natural logarithm, so base is e here, understood. If the base is not e, something else, say like log of x to the base a, then that will be 1 by x, but here base we have to change, e to the base a, that will come. So remember this, d by dx of a to the power x, e to the power x is e to the power x, but a to the power x is a to the power x log a, like this. So these are some common formula, and for very quick, although this is not formula, but 1 by x is minus 1 by x square, you may remember, and d by dx of root x is 1 by 2 root x. Although this will come from the formula, but if you remember this, this will be very useful. Now, let us do some questions, some examples on the basis of this, how to find derivative of function. One more thing, that if u and v be two functions and c is any constant term, say c is any constant term, then c will come outside and du by dx, where c is any constant. C is any constant, right? So if constant is multiplied somewhere in the function, then constant can be taken outside and derivative of function can take place, right? Now, some more thing is that d by dx of u plus v are two function, then this can be operated like du by dx operated plus d by dx of v. So that will be also. Similarly, d by dx of u minus v is there, then you write here d by dx of u minus d by dx of v as well. There is no problem, right? Now, we can use some questions. Even there are number of terms are there. Say u plus v minus w is equal to. So similar, like you can use it du by dx plus d by dx of v. And if there is minus sign, so you write dw by dx as well. There is no problem at all. So I hope you got it. Now, there is one formula which is called product formula. But before going with the product formula, let us do some questions. Questions are like d by dx of x to the power 3. As per formula, d by dx of, since d by dx of x to the power n is n x to the power n minus 1, this is the formula. So using this, the power is multiplied here. This power to be multiplied here. And power is reduced by minus 1. So we can write answer of this is 3, power is multiplier and x to the power 3 minus 1, that is called 3x square. This is the first question. Second question is d by dx of x to the power 7. Then what will happen? 7x to the power 7 minus 1, that is 7x to the power 6, etc. So I hope you got this, right now. Now the third one is, say like this. Third one is, question third is d by dx of 5x to the power 4. Here constant is multiplied, so constant can be taken outside, and x to the power 4, that you have to find derivative. So 5 into power is multiplied and x to the power 4 minus 1, that is 5 4 are 20, x to the power 3, that will come. Now some other questions of the same category can be d by dx of 3x square plus 5. So what will be that? That is operated like d by dx of 3x square plus d by dx of 5. Now here constant can be taken outside, so 3 d by dx of x square, and derivative of constant is 0, and derivative of x square is what? 2x. Power is multiply and power is reduced by 1. So 3 to the 6x, that will be answer. So like that, some every question is different from the others. Now one more question is there, d by dx of x 2x to the power 7 plus 3x to the power 6 plus 5x cube minus 7x plus 8, like this. This is a question. So how to deal with this? That can be written as d by dx of 2x to the power 7, isn't it? Plus d by dx of 3x to the power 6 plus d by dx of 5x to the power cube minus d by dx of 7x and plus d by dx of 8, right? So you will write here again in the similar fashion. We will write here 2 is taken outside, d by dx of x to the power 7. 3 is taken outside and d by dx of x to the power 6. 5 is taken outside and d by dx of x to the power 3. 7 is taken outside and d by dx of x, right? And here this is 0. Everybody knows this. Derivative of constant is 0. Now we can write again 2 into x to the power 7 is 7x to the power 6. 3 into this is 6x to the power 5. 5 into 3x square and 7 dx by dx is 1. So the finally answer will come 14x to the power 6 plus 18x to the power 5 plus 15x cube x square and minus 7. 15x square and minus 15x square minus 7, and that will be the answer. So I hope you got it. All this, how to operate. Now there is a formula that is called product rule. Product rule. What is that? If u and v are any two functions, u and v are function of x. Function of x, then derivative of d by dx of u into v. H, there is the product of two functions, u as it is derivative of v plus v as it is derivative of u, like this. This is a formula which can be used, and any one of them can be taken first and derivative of second, and then derivative of second one is kept as it is and derivative of first. So here this is the formula, and that formula is called product rule, right? So this you should remember this formula is called product rule. Now let us find some questions on the basis of this. Question is here, and the question is d by dx of x cos x, like this. So there are two type of function, one is x, another is cos x. So we can use this formula, take x as it is, d by dx of cos x, derivative of cos x, plus cos x as it is, d by dx of x. We can write like this. So what will happen? In that case, the derivative of cos is minus sin x. So we will write minus sin x, and cos x by cos dx by dx is 1. So that is 1, right now? So it will be minus x sin x plus cos x. That is answer, right? Now, similarly, some other questions can be also taken into consideration. Like, let us do some more questions. Like question number 2, d by dx of sin x into sin x into log x, right? Now, sin x into log x, like this. So we can take it sin x as it is, d by dx of log x, right? And plus log x as it is, and we will write a d by dx of, means derivative of whom? Sin x. So further you can write it sin x derivative of log x is 1 by x plus log x, and derivative of sin x is cos x. So that will be answer. That is sin x by x and cos x log x. Answer. Right? So like this. Some more questions I would like to discuss. Third question is, here d by dx of sin x plus x into cos x plus e to the power x, like this. These are two functions and derivative of that is given. So how to deal with this question? So we can write it here. First function, say this is the product of two functions. So first function as it is, we will write d by dx of cos x plus e to the power x, isn't it? Plus cos x plus e to the power x as it is. And now we will write d by dx of sin x plus x. So what will happen? Sin x plus x is there, right? and we will write here derivative of cos x is minus sin x, and derivative of e to the power x is e to the power x. We will operate one by one because it will hold distributive law like this. And here again, cos x plus e to the power x into derivative of sin x is cos x plus derivative of x with respect to x is 1, dx by dx is 1. So that will be answer. No need to simplify them. Even without simplifying this, you can write answer. And because they wanted to know the way of differentiation, whether you know or not. Now, the another type of things is called quotient rule. Quotient rule. And what is that? Try to understand. Quotient rule, if u and v are any two function, u and v are function of x, then dy dx of u by v is what? V into derivative of u minus u into derivative of v whole divided by denominator square, that is v square. So v square, this is the formula, and you have to apply this. Here first come first serve basis. You remember this and must note down that first come first serve basis. First is u, so derivative of u will take place. You can't do here arbitrary. You can do it arbitrary in product rule, that anyone can be taken first and anyone can be taken second. But here in quotient rule, this is necessary that you should apply on first come first serve basis. So u is nearer to d, so it will be derivative of u should be taken first, and v will be as it is, and then there is a negative sign. U will be as it is, derivative of v, and divided by denominator whole square. So considering the same concept, here is some examples. I can take dy dx of cos x by x like this. What to do? So we'll write here x as it is, dy dx of cos x, isn't it? Minus cos x as it is, dy dx of x whole divided by x square. So what will come? That will come up x, and derivative of cos x is minus sin x, and minus cos x dx by dx is 1, and divided by x square. So that will be minus of x sin x minus cos x divided by x square. You can take minus common and put here positive sign, but that is a separate thing, that is algebraic work. Now there is next question, dy dx of x plus sin x upon x minus sin x like this, and this is the question. So how to deal with? Again, there will be a quotient rule will be applied, that you can write x minus sin x first and derivative of x plus sin x, and then you will write minus sin x plus sin x and derivative of dy dx of x minus sin x, right? Okay, whole divided by denominator whole square. So what we'll write? You will write it denominator, that is x minus sin x whole square, right? So here the things will come like x minus sin x, and the derivative of x is 1, and derivative of sin x is cos x, minus x plus sin x as it is, and derivative of x is 1, and derivative of sin x is cos x, and because there is a negative sign, so I put here negative sign, divided by x minus sin x whole square, divided by x minus sin x whole square, right? So we'll write it x by sin x whole square, right? X by sin x whole square. We will write here. That will be x by sin x whole square. So what is that? X minus sin x whole square. and that will be answer. You can simplify, but this is an algebraic work and you can do it your own. I hope you will do it nicely. Make some practice questions from the booklet, and this is a question tool, product tool, and basic knowledge about differentiation has been discussed. In next class, that is after break, we will discuss some more about differentiation and chain rule and implicit function, logarithmic function and all. So till then, keep watching. God bless, and thank you very much for watching this, and please subscribe this channel and don't forget to share with your friends. That's all in this lecture. Hopefully you have enjoyed it and you learn the basic of differentiation and meaning of differentiation as well. So thank you very much. God bless.